Okay, let's consider a little bit more of the properties of elasticity of a linear demand curve. So we have this expression as the formula for the elasticity. And note, this Qn minus Q0 over Pn minus P0 does not change as you move along the demand curve. This is the inverse of the slope of this, but the slope of this is a constant, so the inverse is also a constant. It doesn't change. What does change is P0 over Q0, the slope of the line from the origin to the curve. That gets bigger as you move up the demand curve in this direction, and again, if we move the original price up, note the elasticity is getting bigger. I'm going to move it back down, and the elasticity gets smaller. So the elasticity changes on each point of the demand curve, and the demand curve gets more elastic at higher prices. The next point to note is that economists break up demand elasticity into regions where demand is insensitive to a price change, and we say it is inelastic. And that's if this number, the elasticity number, is less than 1 in absolute value. So demand is inelastic if this number is less than 1. Demand is elastic if that number is greater than 1 in absolute value. So the borderline case is where demand is unitary elastic, where the elasticity is exactly equal to 1. This purple curve that goes through the same point as on the demand curve at the original price has unitary elasticity at every single point on the curve. It's unitary elastic everywhere. And what's happening at this point is the original demand curve is steeper than the unitary elastic one. So the original demand curve is less elastic than the unitary one, so it must be inelastic here. Let's now raise price a lot and go to the case where you can see that demand is highly elastic here, and now the linear demand curve is flatter than the unitary elastic demand curve at this point. And because it's flatter than the unitary elastic demand curve, it must itself be elastic. Finally, let's go to the point where the demand elasticity on the linear curve is exactly 1. I think that's at price 50. Yeah, there we go. Notice that at this point, the unitary elastic demand curve is actually tangent to the linear demand curve at that point. So you can get the relationship of the demand elasticity by looking at the unitary elastic demand curve through the same point and comparing the relative slopes of the two curves.